Hello, hello, Playing for Fun King here again, back with another video, and we are gonna continue the game. We are still in ALFHEIM, and then we are gonna do a side story, a side quest. So I'm really excited about this. We are gonna try to find the wounded animal from the last episode. We didn't see it, but we heard it. So I'm really excited to do this. All right, without any delay, let's do it.
We should be able to reach the barons up top once we find a way past this.
I remember these things. Definitely dark elf territory.
Hail, fellow travelers!
Atreus heard a creature in pain in the desert.
Over a storm like this? Most impressive.
You know ALFHEIM pretty well, right? Do you have any idea what's out there?
No, sorry. The elves and I... Long story, but it's best when we keep out of each other's way. Hive matter is... stickier than I care for. Good luck on your search, though. Stuff some cloth in your ears to keep the sand out. Don't knock it till you've tried it. I'm here for you. This axe just keeps getting stronger. Oh, got time to chat?
What are these animals?
Gulag. native to Vanaheim. Not sure what they're doing here.
Someone trained them to pull a sled. Lucky for us.
Domesticated Gulon. Most unusual. Particular direction to find your wounded animal? Or are we just enjoying the weather?
I can't hear anything out here.
Perhaps we find a cave first to catch our bearings?
Look! There's a cave entrance!
Desert. Is the creature within?
Yeah, sounds like it. We'll find it if we keep going. What is this place?
A refuge for the Dark Elves, by the looks of it. One of the few remaining now that they're barred from the temple.
Great. Their home. And considering what happened the last time we were in ALFHEIM, can you really blame them?
Thank you.
patience a virtue or a threat?
Depends on the reader. The creature you heard. What does it say now?
It's not always like that. Some animals are just... I feel what they're feeling, you know? And whatever this thing is, it's in a lot of pain.
I see.
Why do you ask?
I am curious.
Really?
I am capable of curiosity.
Okay. Behind you, Father!
The wee bastard's about to explode!
Get out! Or enchanted rings or whatever.
Much has changed for both of us.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to figure out why you've helped some random animal.
Is this not what you want?
No, it is. I'm just surprised it's what you want too.
I remember a young lad whom, until this very moment, would take on an army of draugr to save a wounded animal.
But these aren't undead Draugr. They're elves. I just want to make sure we're not repeating the same mistakes. Getting involved where we shouldn't.
Bomb should help us out.
It's just, why does it feel like no matter what we do in ALFHEIM, we wind up hurting Dark Elves?
We are down here to help the creature you heard.
I know that, but I'm usually the one who drags us around trying to rescue animals. Why do you care so much? Is there something you're not telling me?
No.
Thank you.
the largest bloody half you I've ever laid eyes on.
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the song of the sands. They don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, Lunch. I'll get you out.
What is that name?
Well, the last good thing you saw was Mjölnir, so...
Oh boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that, little brother, is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, can't all be winners.
Of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
Why did they trap it down here?
Halfgifers are known to burrow. Well, I'd hesitate to place full blame on our dark elf friends.
But it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the Dark Elves, any more than the light belongs to the Light Elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources. One the Elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the Light Elves seem keen to banish the hive over on their side, the Dark Elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this hive, are we hurting Dark Elves?
We wish to leave the creature enslaved.
No.
Then let us free it.
What? My face is itchy. I think my beard's coming in.
Is it?
Yeah. On my jawline. See? It's growing.
Is it?
That's not just dirt.
It's not dirt. There's something I'm not sure I quite understand. In the Ragnarok prophecy, Odin knows all the realms get destroyed, including Asgard. In the version Groa kept secret, Asgard still falls. Wouldn't Odin have tried to prevent it either way? What difference would their life really make?
I think of it this way. When it comes to subverting prophecy, knowledge is power. Without the full picture, the con... The finer details can lead you to tragically incorrect interpretations. Back in my homeland, I was privy to the operations of a certain coven of heat witches who were keen on destabilizing the government. They picked an influential thane, an otherwise loyal man, and fed him a story of his own ascension to king. They dressed it up in enough details they knew it would come to pass, so when they did, the thane took it as confirmation.
Enough. We will continue later.
This is the spot. We can cut the half Koopa loose here.
It's a half goofer.
Sounds much happier now. And hey, the storm's gone.
Aye, perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here. You don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered... He just wants to spend time with you, lad. While he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead. But if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
Nothing, brother. Just... You ever have those moments where you wish you could go back? Rewrite your own past. Make different decisions.
Journeying through time is more trouble than it is worth.
Ah, fair point. You're speaking metaphorically, right?
No.
Of course you're not. Yeah.
Father, what was Spartan training like?
Unforgiving.
Is that why you didn't train me like one? Did you not think I could handle it?
I did not think you should have had to.
What's that?
A diagram for a sword hilt.
Perhaps we should show it to one of the dwarves. They'll know what to do with it. Shield holding up black.
It's good. I always knew Sindri was a great blacksmith, but this magical shield, it just feels natural.
The shield is well made, but it is you who wields it with skill.
Thanks. Looks like a lot of the sand is cleared up, but there's another storm out that way. I think that means...
Another half gufa.
The chisel will not open this.
Did the light elves put this lock here? Why would they care what happens in the barren?
A fair question. But until we find the right key, that poor half gufa will have to continue its solo act. Returning to my anecdote about the Heath Witches, they fed the Thane a prophecy of his ascension to king.
Old. We will finish later.
Father, what's the biggest thing you've ever fought?
I do not know.
You can't remember?
Why do you ask?
I don't know. So we can compare?
It is not a competition.
I mean, not yet.
Returning to my anecdote about the Heath Witches, they fed the Thane a prophecy of his ascension to king. Next thing you know, he's helping matters along. He murders his king, sleeping under his own roof.
Let this wait. Stay alert.
That really sucks.
Hold that thought. about to get violent. Reminds me of tales of a cruel empress, one too angry to die.
We will see.
We build a lyre together?
The instrument. Why?
We hunt, train. Those are the only two things you do to distract yourself.
They are not distractions.
Oh, of course not.
I just thought it'd be nice to learn some music. You could teach me, and... No. It's stupid. Never mind.
Story. A queen of my homeland, manipulated by prophecy, welcomes his king as a guest and murders him in his sleep. Murders many he once called friends, too, thinking them fated to oppose him. Then, for a finishing touch, the witches revisit this usurper. With just a few details structured ever so misleadingly, they convinced the fool he was invulnerable to all threats.
Physical or magical?
Aye. But 'twas not so for him. All turned into a rather magnificent bloodbath as they go. The Thane ends up without his head and a name so cursed, none dare speak it. All thanks to a subtly deceptive prophecy.
You really gotta write these stories down one day, Mimir.
Well, I try. Jaw tends to get sore, but thank you, lad.
Alright, Tim, I think this is gonna be it.
How can I help?
Oh, I have special items.
This must be from ALFHEIM. Explains the, sand.
Thanks for grabbing this. Surprised to see you out here, Sindri. You must hate the sand.
Oh, it is the worst. But with Brock banned from Alfheim, it's up to me to keep you ship-shape and sharp.
So why is Brock banned from Alfheim?
Oh, that's, I don't know if... Well, do you know what a juicy gnocchi is?
No.
Well, thanks to Brock, the elves sure do.
What is a juicy...
No.
Well, I hope Tyr's had enough time to find his equilibrium, or whatever.
Indeed. I saw flashes of the old god of war in them, but they were fleeting.
There is nothing wrong with opposing war, nor opposing prophecy.
I suppose that's fair. Never can be quite sure what the Giants meant by any of it.
Am I the only one that remembers they predicted our entire journey to Jotunheim? If the Giants saw Tyr leading armies at Ragnarok, I believe that.
The question is, how you'll ever make Tyr believe it.
Alright, team. We are gonna stop for today. And we are gonna continue again later. Alright, have a wonderful day.